Daddy, so much to be thankful for.
Oh, yes.
Amen. I want to say there's so much to be thankful for. David said, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. That sounds like a decision. That sounds like a decision. No one controls that mother but you. You follow me? You can let it slip away from you. And you'd be surprised at the things that come to take your joy. You'd be surprised of the little bitty things that come to steal your joy. That don't, mother don't even have nothing to do with destiny.
Come on now.
But it come to steal your destiny.
That's true.
Come to take your joy. You follow what I'm saying, Sister John?
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yes, sir.
You know, you got to make a decision to be happy. You got to make a decision to continue.
Yes.
You follow what I'm saying?
Yes.
You have to make a decision to display joy in every situation of your life. You follow what I'm saying? You may be walking in a disqualified situation. But even in the midst of that, you got to make a decision that I will rejoice.
Amen.
See, it's people that are rejoicing, people that are happy, people that walk in the joy of the Lord, they have a certain a swag about them.
Mm-hmm.
They got a certain comeback about them.
Yes.
They got some I'm not going to quit about them. That may not be good English, but they got some I'm not going to quit.
Yeah.
I can't give up. They got some, I come too far to turn around.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Like you hear my grandmother say, I come this far.
Amen.
You know what I'm going to say, mother? By faith. And right. You know the song that went with that. You follow what I'm saying?
Amen.
I come this far. You should hear that song as a little boy. I come this far by faith.
Mm-hmm.
Come too far to turn around.
Mm-hmm.
See, that's when you determine. That's when you persistent. That's when you begin to walk in bulldog faith.
Yes.
Come on now.
Come on here. That's when you begin to reach above the cup. You follow what I'm saying? Even though the rope, you're hanging from the ceiling of life.
Yes. Come on now.
And some of the rope is about to fall. But let the bottom fall, but you reach above the cup, there's still rope to hang on to.
Amen.
There's still hope to hang on to. You follow what I'm saying?
Yes,
reach above it. Someone said, you got to reach above it.
Reach above it.
Come on, you got to reach above disappointment.
Amen.
You got to reach above sickness. You got to reach above failure.
Mm-hmm.
You follow what I'm saying, mother?
Amen. Right.
You got to reach above rejection. You got to reach above attitude.
Mm-hmm.
You got to reach above what looks like it's not in your favor. Mm-hmm. Just because it looks like it's not in your favor don't mean that it ain't in your favor.
Come on now.
Come on here. And you follow what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
God is known for making the crooked places straight. He's known for making the unfavorable favorable.
Mm-hmm.
He's known for making the impossible possible.
Right.
Come on now.
Are you following what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Are you hearing this truth?
Yes, sir.
God knows your address. He knows where you're at.
Yes, he does.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
See, you can't give up on the God in you.
Amen.
Christ in you, the hope of glory. When you give up, you're giving up on God, on the God in you.
Come on now.
When we feel like we're tired and don't want to go no further, that means we're resorting back to our own strength.
Mm-hmm.
We're relying upon our own self.
Amen.
You follow what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But when you begin to dig deep in the resources of your inward self and locate your God self, you know the battle's not over.
Mm-hmm.
Because he said, I won't put more on you than you can bear. Mm-hmm. Lord, I can't take no more. Yeah, you can. If it's there, you can take it. If you're there, you can take it. Are you hearing me, Sister John?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Now you don't let darkness overcome you. You overcome darkness with light,
yes.
With revelation, with truth.
Yes.
You don't let a lie win.
Come on now.
You don't let a lie win.
That's right.
You let the truth win.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. No. I wasn't created by defeat, so
come
defeat can't identify me. I was created by sickness, so sickness can't decide my timeline.
Come on now.
Whatever happening in my body, if it ain't God, it has to line up with God.
Come on
now. It
has
to line up with the Word of God.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it does.
You follow what I'm saying? Whatever's happening in my finances, in my economical situation, it has to line up with the Word of God.
Amen.
You follow what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Because when I read the word of God, the word kicks in with God letting it be.
Amen.
It kicks in and says, let it be.
Mm-hmm.
You know, let it be. Let it be.
Amen.
Let it be. And God ain't stopped letting yet.
Hello.
He's still letting it be.
Say,
come on here. When I look back over my life, I'm like, my God, he did let it be.
Yes,
you hear? Come on, you know you can look back and you know God let it be. Because
yes.
You know that wasn't you.
Mm-hmm.
You know you wouldn't be in there if God hadn't let it be. He let it be.
Right.
Are you hearing me, Mother?
Amen.
He let it be.
Right.
When you were sick and the doctor said one thing, mm-hmm. and he said you need to be on this medicine, you be, and you ain't touched none of it, 6 years later, he's still letting it be.
All right.
I know that's right. Amen.
Is anybody hearing this truth?
Yes, sir.
Come on. When the finances say one thing, but God say, I say let it be above what the system say.
That's right.
Is anybody hearing this here?
Yes, sir.
Let that be. Let it be to the mind of God. Let it be what God say. Come on, not from the reasoning of man.
Come on now.
Don't let your logic begin to come in competition with your faith.
Come on, said
that again. Don't allow your logic to come in competition with your faith. What is your logic? Priest is your mind. Don't allow your carnal mind to come in competition with your faith. Because the carnal mind want to always reason
mm-hmm.
with your faith.
Mm-hmm.
Well, but then, now you know the doctor said this here. Now you know
mm-hmm.
you know you're of this age, so you can't buy own no house. Well, you want a house. You got one?
No. Say,
come on here. If it's legal, anything legal in the land, I can have.
Yes, I
think. Age don't disqualify. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
If it's legal, I can have it. Come on here. You ain't got to be disqualified by age.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't got to be disqualified by the way things appear. Is anybody here? Are you hearing this gesture?
Yes.
See what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You decide.
Yes.
You decide. Come on now, we ain't got no church God. This is a kingdom God.
Amen.
We don't have no church God.
Come on now.
We don't have no church God. There ain't no church God.
Mm-hmm.
Church God. Come on, you need a kingdom God.
Come on.
I don't know about you, I need a 24/7, 365 God.
Come on now.
Come on here. A God that'll go where I go.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll go where he go.
Yes.
I'm just hearing this truth.
Yes, sir.
Are y'all hearing this here?
Mm-hmm.
Come on here. You know, I was sharing with my wife. Many people want a lot of things, but they don't want to make the sacrifice.
That's right.
They don't want to make the sacrifice for it. They want a lot, pray a lot, but come out of praying, got no sacrifice. No tolerance for sacrifice. Life is not a given. Life is it's taking it by force. It's not a given. If you're sitting there waiting for life to give you something, life is not going to give you nothing. You got to seed yourself into it. You got to seed yourself into the moment. You ain't heard nothing I said. Maybe it ain't happened because you ain't seeded yourself into the moment.
Come on, man.
Are you hearing me, Sister Joe? You got to seed yourself into the moment. But long as you feel disqualified, long as you feel like that you don't have what it takes, then the universe pick up that environment. And so the universe said, well, she don't have what it takes. So the universe, life start giving you that response. Because within you, that's what you sending out.
Mm-hmm.
But when you begin to seed yourself into the moment, come on here.
All right.
That's called a plan of action.
Ooh,
I want it now. I got to seed myself into the moment.
Mm-hmm.
Prophet Johnson, why you won't quit? Because I've seeded myself into the moment, and I'm not going to ply myself up.
Come on now.
Come on here. God allowed me to seed myself into the moment, so now I'm waiting for God to harvest me.
Amen.
I'm waiting for God to present me. Come on here. I'm being watered with his spirit. I'm being watered with his power. I'm being watered with his ability. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I'm being watered with his faith. I'm being watered with his patience. I'm being watered with his wisdom. I'm being watered with his knowledge. Is anybody hearing me? Oh, it's not in vain. Every faith step you take is not in vain. Come on here. I watched Mother Ford walk on the door. Just talking about her this morning. I said, they can say what they want, but one thing I can't say. I'm talking about this right here in her life. I said, she's going to sacrifice.
Amen.
I was talking about those that made sure and those that wouldn't. And look who popped in the door. See, the sacrifice. How bad do you want it? It's never too late. You can't keep talking about it. Well, look, I missed time, I wait. Bump the time you waste. You can't go back in time and change nothing. But what are you going to do right now?
Say.
What are you going to make happen in your life and happen to somebody else's life?
Come on now.
Everybody is responsible for a legacy. Everybody is responsible for followers. Everybody is responsible for somebody to follow their voice. Somebody to imitate their truth. There's somebody believe just like you believe. You just got to get connected to it.
Come on now.
Somebody mother's thinking just like you thinking.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
That's why you can't give right thinking Brother Anthony an off day.
Amen.
And I'm telling you, just like you mindful of people, somebody's mindful of you.
Mm-hmm.
You can't have nobody on your heart without God mother having somebody on your heart.
That's right.
Are you following me?
Amen.
Just like you order your voice to pray for somebody praying for you.
Amen.
They could be riding down the street and just call out your name.
Right.
I'm good to do it. I'm good to say I don't have no little secret corner.
Come on.
Sometimes
now.
I'm in my car praying for y'all. Sometimes I like to be walking in a restaurant uttering y'all's name. You ain't hear nothing. As it come across my mind, I praise it.
Amen.
I heard my wife say, somebody told her one time years ago, say, I want you to pray for me. She started praying for him right then.
Mm-hmm.
He said, well, you said pray, so you said, so I'll do it right now.
Say.
While it's on my mind.
That's right.
Come on now.
Mm-hmm.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Come on. Go to Proverbs. Go to Proverbs. And we're going to tap into some wisdom this morning. Proverbs the 20th chapter, starting with verse 27. The spirit of a man is the candle of the Lord, searching all the inward parts of the belly. Mercy and truth preserve the king, and his throne is upheld by mercy. Is anybody hearing that truth?
Mm-hmm.
The spirit of the man is the candle of the Lord. Spirit of a man is light. It's the candle of the Lord. Who keeps that candle lit? God keeps that candle lit. Come on in. You stay where light is, you'll be light. You stay where wisdom is, you'll be wisdom. You stay where knowledge is, you'll have knowledge. When your candle go out, it's because you done put something over it. You done put something first place over the light. You want to dim the light, put a shade over it. It may be still lit, but it could give off more light if you move the shade.
Mm-hmm.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
The shade of ignorance, the shade of doubt, the shade of fear, the shade of complaint. The biggest enemy against success is the way you feel. You ain't hear nothing I said. The biggest enemy of success is the way you feel. You can miss your moments feeling like you don't want to do it.
Come on now.
Hear me, preach. The biggest moment in life is, the biggest enemy in life is how you feel. Your feelings will deceive you. Your spirit will hold on, but your feelings kick in your emotions.
Mm-hmm.
And make you, and mother, make you begin to do things that you really feel.
Mm-hmm.
Something you've been waiting on from a little girl.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden, feelings kick in one day and want to stop you from doing what you know is right to do.
Come on now.
Right don't always feel good. Can I say that to you?
Yes,
right
sir.
Don't always feel good. The place of God don't always seem like the place of God. Mother, you've been doing right and it didn't feel good. Come on now, just be real. Have you ever been doing right and it just didn't feel like it was right?
Mm-hmm.
You felt like you were wrong.
Mm-hmm.
I may feel like this, but I'm not going to let the lie in you destroy my truth.
Say.
Somebody here, nothing you see.
Say.
Huh? I may be trying to feel, but I ain't gonna let what I feel pull out, nullify the truth in me.
Okay.
I'm gonna show you a scripture in a minute. Are you hearing that? Are y'all hearing this truth?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. You gotta be able to continue, Margo, against the odds.
Hello,
YouTube world. You got to be able to continue against the odds. You know, you got to be able to put your all into these spiritual principles. It's not enough just to say, yo, I know God. Do God know you?
Come on now.
I'm telling you, know God. To the standpoint, you're not going to be shaken by what don't look like God. If God said it, I'm going to hold on for dear life.
Amen.
Guess what? Guess whose reputation? If Mother of God tell you something, guess whose first reputation is on the line? God's, not yours. I can be going west. I could be going west or east or whichever way direction is here. Depending on the way you're looking at it. And all of a sudden, God say, now go back to the right, go back to the east. Mm-hmm. Who's reputation on the line? I ain't going to keep going in the same direction, knowing God had changed direction.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Just to save my integrity.
Come on.
Do what God is doing.
Hello.
You know what I do, Mother? I follow favor. That's how I know when God's praying. I follow favor.
Yeah, yes.
And you know what? Sometimes favor don't look that great, but I know it's favor. I know it's something about a peace come over me. Somebody, a burden's lifted. You've been trying to crack a door, Mother, trying to get in somewhere, and God wasn't moving that door. That didn't mean that he wasn't going to give you that desire. But all of a sudden, he gave you that door. But all of a sudden, the peace came with that door.
Come on now.
You was beating on this door, but it was stressful. But God, I want it. It don't mean, come on here, that he ain't going to give it to you. But I need you to step here. I need you to make this step, the steps of a good man.
Come on now.
All about the Lord. I need you to step right here. Sometimes you want to jump on the porch before you hit the steps.
Come on now.
See, I know homes now, they don't have a lot of steps. You just walk right on in. Mm-hmm. But back in the day, it was steps. You had a porch. Y'all remember the porch?
Uh-huh.
Every house had a porch. You know what I'm talking about, Mother? Uh-huh. You could see it before they hit the porch. See, we just ready to get in, but there are steps that you got to take. And then if you made it to the porch, it qualified whether the door would be open or not. Because you would look out the peephole and see what's, you ain't here, does not see.
Save.
If you qualify to move from the porch.
Save.
You ain't here, does not see. Because back in those days, to get on the porch, you to mess with them steps, you had to know that that was the place.
Save.
Because you just didn't step anywhere. You hear the wisdom. Mm-hmm. Proverbs 21, verse 20. There is treasure to be desired in all in the dwelling of the wise, but a foolish man spinneth it up. He that followeth after righteousness and mercy findeth life, righteousness and honor. There is treasure to be desired in all in the dwelling of the wise. There's treasure, there's an anointing. There's treasure, there's an anointing. Listen to this, Mother. There is treasure to be desired in an anointing in the dwelling of the wise, but a foolish man spinneth it up. Come on. Something about hanging around the wise of God. There's an anointing to be released. There's treasure to gain. Wisdom is treasure. Come on here. Because money is hid in a wisdom.
Come on now.
I said money. Your money ain't kept in your wallet. It's kept in a wisdom. You ain't hear nothing I just said. Oh, you hear me, sir? Brother Anthony. Money is in a wisdom. When you tap into the wisdom, and in the wisdom is the voice of God.
Come on now.
God unlocked the floodgates from a wisdom. Are we hearing that?
Mm-hmm.
God unlocked the floodgates from a wisdom. It's wisdom nuggets, wisdom, are keys and principles that unlock doors.
Mm-hmm.
You will say something and somebody say, can you meet me at 10? I want you to say that again in front of this person. Now your life is changing because you tapped into a wisdom. A conversation could be worth billions, millions, and billions of dollars. In wisdom, your health could be hid in a wisdom. You hear nothing I see. You're looking for the health, for the wisdom in a bottle of medicine, And God said, I got the health and the wisdom.
Come on now.
If they hear this, they won't need that.
Say.
If they just change this diet and do this, they won't need that. So I'm going to say it's in the wisdom.
It's in the wisdom.
He that falleth after righteousness and mercy findeth life. He that falleth after righteousness. What was righteousness? Right standing. Mm-hmm. He that falleth to be in right standing with God in everything that he does. Have we seen that?
Mm-hmm.
In case you can't forfeit it, there's some mercy there too.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't read nothing I see. Huh? Are you reading this here?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Reading this here? He that followed after righteousness, and then he said, oh, hold on, and mercy. Because
mm-hmm.
on your best day, you better not be good enough.
Come on now.
He said, righteousness and mercy. Mm-hmm. Step forward. See, I believe mercy, God give us mercy so we won't be copping out, having excuses.
Amen.
Oh, God, well, this came to my mind. Oh, God, would this action happen? God is bigger than your action.
Yes.
He said, I try a man by the rings of his heart.
Come on now.
Have you ever, Sister Joan, have you ever mean well and found out in the end it was something stupid happened?
Mm-hmm.
You ever meant well?
Yes.
You woke up meaning well?
Yes.
And then by two, it was drama?
Yes.
It was... And you know in your mind, you didn't mean for life to go this way.
Yeah.
You're like, wait a minute, I done prayed and I done spoke. What is this?
Mm-hmm.
Am I the only one been there?
Mm-hmm.
Mother, you've
no,
been there?
Sir.
You have woke up with mind to make it happen,
yes.
Do good,
yes.
And all of a sudden drama hit by 1 o'clock.
Yes.
Huh?
That's right.
Then an enemy want to begin to talk to your soul. See, I told you. Mm-hmm. I told you you wasn't good enough. Told you, this, that, and the other. But I remember the scripture said, by mercy and truth,
mm-hmm.
iniquity is purged.
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad it ain't by truth, because the truth is, you ain't good enough. He said, mercy before truth.
Come on now.
He said, by truth and mercy, by mercy and truth,
mm-hmm.
iniquity is purged.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't say, my truth is new every day. He said, my mercy is new every
day.
My truth remains the same. But because my truth stands, I got to give you some new mercy that will balance you out with the truth. That you don't become condemned.
Hello.
And give up the race when you're right at the finish line. See, the enemy knows, mother, when it starts working on you, on your mind, you right there. You right there.
Right.
You right there, mother. Mm-hmm. Is anybody hearing this truth?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. He that falleth after righteousness and mercy findeth life. Say, findeth life.
Findeth life.
Righteousness and honor. And honor. Huh? And honor. And where there's honor, there's favor. And where there's honor, there's finances. Real honor always gonna bring increase. Come on. No one can just honor you with a piece of paper.
Come on now.
Mother, when you honor, there's gift things come. There's gifts come with that. There's revenue come with that.
Mm-hmm.
Are you following me?
Mm-hmm.
The Bible says this here. It says, where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. It didn't say where your heart is, there will your treasure be. It said where your treasure is. If we can trace your treasure, we'll find your heart.
Come on now.
Anyone that can't give it to you, they don't love you. You ain't hear nothing I see. Are you hearing me, Sister Joan?
Yes, sir.
You can find out where a person is, chase their money down. Chase where they put their money. You'll find out where their heart is.
Come on now.
No, don't look for the heart first. Because that can be deceptive. Huh? That can
all
be deceptive.
Right, all right.
Watch this, Sister Margo. Watch this here. If I take my wallet and put it right here on the table, I put it there. You see me put it there, right?
Mm-hmm.
I can't say I didn't do it because you see me put it there. Ain't no deception in that. Because you seen that. I put it there. But I can talk from my heart and tell you I put it there, but don't mean I put it there. It's different. Where your treasure is, there will be your heart also. A lot of times people ain't got enough invested. That's why they don't care. That's why they can bail out on stuff easy, mother. Because you ain't got an investment. Anybody can just walk away? An argument? Just because we didn't, mother, we ain't got a father because we don't agree. Come on, we disagree. And they say, you know, we talk about this later. We'll let God bring the difference in this here. Mm-hmm. Now, anything you can quit real fast, you ain't had no investment in that anyway. And what I mean by that, I'm talking real investment. Because you work. See, your life is in your money. I said, your life is in your money. I notice how people treat stuff when they ain't got no money involved in it. You ever notice how people treat your car when they ain't got no investment in your car? But watch how they treat theirs, or your house. Watch how people just want to do your house any kind of way. You hear nothing I see. See, that's because ain't no investment. But it makes a difference when you put an investment. I used to counsel people free. I don't do it no more. If I'm going to counsel you, extra beyond the word of God, we're going to see, can you sow? Because if you sow into the knowledge, you won't reject it.
Same.
It's kind of like if you're going to pay to go to college, you're a fool to skip school. Mm-hmm. That's your investment. But if I pay for your college education, you may not go to school. Why? You got nothing invested. Mm-hmm. So you can skip. But when you done paid $50,000 for a semester, you got to be retarded to skip school.
Come on now.
That's why it's more truancy in public school because it's no investment. The truancy level, come on, of attendance is less in private schools where you pay than public school. There's no investment. You can be what you sacrifice to be. Somebody write that down. Are y'all hearing me, young men?
Yes, sir.
You can be what you sacrifice to be. Watch this here. And if you young men want to take off your coat, please, you can if you want to. If you're good with it on, keep it on. But anyway, you can be what you want to be if you sacrifice to be it. But you got to put your all into it. If you won't make time for knowledge in the day of adversity, knowledge won't make time for you. Are you hearing me, mother? If you won't make time for wisdom in the day of adversity, wisdom won't make time for you. I'm always keeping, even against all, I'm going to keep something going through my spirit. Something positive going through my spirit. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Righteousness has a payday. You don't hear nothing I say. Right standing with God, mother, has a payday. Mm-hmm. I don't care what nobody say.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we get our eyes on people that we think should help us. And a lot of times, it ain't even them. They ain't the ones supposed to do it.
Amen.
And you get frustrated because certain people won't help you. And God say, them ain't the ones anyway. I'm just letting them do this for you right now.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll pull ourselves out the race based on what we see. That's why you can't walk natural with this, Brother Michael. You can't be natural with this here.
Amen.
How are you, man? You 17 years old. Man, you know how much life you got ahead of you? Quitting, stopping shouldn't even be an option. Giving up shouldn't even be an option. 10 years from now, you'll just be 27. Life only just begun.
Say.
Your world could change in a thought. You hear nothing I said. I said your world could change in a thought. That's why you ain't got time to waste thoughts. Thoughts become words, and words become things. And things become life. just a thought, change your whole life around. It's good all in you. You can be whatever you want to be. This is not a stop sign in your life. It's a place of a new beginning. God will meet you at the place where you feel stuck. God will meet you at the place where you feel like you can't go no further. God will meet you at the place where you feel alone and want to give up and want to quit and say, I'm tired. God will meet you at that place. And you know what? You ain't got to have a tongue or a long prayer. All you can say, you remember these words, Lord, have mercy on me. Baby, that's all you need. That will carry you the rest of your life. If you don't say nothing to God, but God, have mercy on me. Y'all ain't hear nothing I say. I know what I'm talking about. I ain't just talking. I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about. When you feel like nobody understands you. Mama, daddy, children, siblings, kids, friends, neighbors, been there, done that. Mother, been there, done that. You ever feel like nobody cares? Yeah. I'm talking from a little boy. I ain't talking about a man. I'm talking about crying from a little boy. Mm-hmm. Come on, hit me. But you can make it. Baby, you can make it when the playing field looks uneven.
Come on now.
But it looks like people care more about this person than that person. I've been through all that too. I can tell you about all that too. When you feel like this person got more favor in the family and this person got more favor. And you know what? It ain't none of that. It's just a warfare on the inside of you.
Come on.
It's the enemy trying to mess with your greatness. Because the enemy knows once you ever get a clearance, you can take off. And sometimes God will let your engine roll on the runway. He just let it roll. You ever had a plane just roll? It just sit there for a minute. Come on, you ain't hear nothing I say.
Yeah.
And sometimes you'll see other planes, mother, move in on the same runway yours in. But it ain't your time to leave yet. But you got to watch them take off. You ain't hear nothing I say.
Uh-huh.
Y'all get that in a minute. You rode a plane, mother, and you thought you was finna go. You done board it. They got your luggage on. You buckled up. You roll it, and then you come to a stop. We'll be leaving in 15 minutes. We have three other planes that's going to step before us. But my God, I was here first. Don't you unbuckle, don't you get off the plane. Because as soon as there's a clearance, you're going to take off.
Yeah, amen.
Just stay on the plane. Stay on the plane of righteousness. Stay on the plane of success. The plane of destiny. The plane where you guarantee the land to rise in land. Make it to your destination. You can hear nothing I say. You better hear what I'm saying. Y'all hear this truth?
Yes, sir.
Are you hearing this truth? You can't afford to quit. It's expensive to quit. Let me say that again. It's expensive, mother, to quit. It costs more to quit than it does to start.
Come on now.
Y'all, somebody, you ain't heard nothing I just said.
Yeah.
Did you hear that, Dr. Priest? It's expensive to quit. It costs more to quit than it do to start. Is anybody hearing this here?
Yes, sir.
Ignorance is really, you think education is high? Ignorance is more higher. Ignorance is real expensive. It'll cost you.
Yeah.
It'll cost you your life. Is anybody hearing this truth?
Mm-hmm.
Are y'all hearing this truth?
Mm-hmm.
Well, are you hearing this truth?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Are we hearing this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Mm. I feel the anointing of God. Proverbs 19, verse 18. Listen to this, Mike. This is your day. This is your day. God wants to speak to your greatness. There's a lot of Mikes out there. Your name just happened to be Michael. But I'm talking to you, but I'm talking to a lot of Michaels when I'm talking. Well, my name's Susie, but today your name Michael. Proverbs 19 and 18 says, chasten thy son while there is hope, and let not thy soul spare for his crying. Chasten means discipline. Discipline thy son while there is hope, and let not thy soul spare for his crying. Don't be moved by emotions.
Come on now.
When truth is available. Don't be moved by the excuses. You know, people be crying, making excuses for failure. Mother, I just see people crying, making excuses for failure. And I thought they had a legit argument. Crying and hollering and screaming, and they ain't even got a legit argument. But when you pack the truth, you can't be moved by that. You don't know what I've been through. No more than God has been through. No more than the Son. Have you been nailed on the cross physically? Have you been mistreated spiritually? Well, you ain't went through nothing. You talking about a water bill, light bill. What is that? Well, you know, I lost my home, okay, Ian? It's people lost with homes. It's people lost in the house. So what is you saying? I didn't have no mother or father. It's people have mother and father and totally disconnected.
Come on now.
They don't even know their son or daughter. They just got a room in the house. You hear nothing I see? Huh? My grandson loves computers when he come over. I go in there and check on him sometimes. Sometimes I make him come out. He got his own world. He's an entrepreneur at a young age, and he just loves technology. He loves technology. Sometimes I come and bring him out the room and just talk to him. I'm going to rub his head and kiss him on the forehead. I didn't want nothing. I just want to kiss you. You hear what I'm saying? Are you hearing the truth? Come on. I see these young boys here, part of this ministry. I walk up, some of them bigger than me. I rub their head. They ought to be mad. I rub that head. Some of them, I grab their head. They know I'm a head. I get that head. Give me that head. You mad? Give me that head. Give me that head. Want to adjust it. Want to grab that head. They be looking at me. I grab that head. All of them's head. My little prophet back there. When I see him, what I do? Don't I grab that head? Give me that head. I own that head. I got wisdom for it. I'm going to guard that head. Make sure no ignorance get in it.
Amen.
I'm going to multiply that. I know these young men going to represent the prophet.
Yeah.
You hear nothing I say. They all of them going to represent the prophet. Mm-hmm. You see what you see how they in the service, how they be coming up with stuff? You think they ain't listening? Check them and ask them something. They'll drop a bomb on what? You hear a little prophet lady talking about being. What 13 of being and becoming? You know, out of all things he could write. Yeah. And he could write Jesus' love. You know, he said, now being and becoming. See, he's listening with a third ear.
Come on now.
Huh? Well, what are you talking about in church? Well, I mess you up. You better come.
Say it.
You don't want to know that right now. You better just come see. Come see a man that told me all I ever knew.
Come
see. Just come see a man that told me all I ever knew.
Come on, see.
Ooh, yeah, that's it. Private school will cost you all of everything. Don't you be moved by the crowd. Don't you downplay the remedy. It was 12 disciples. How many went to the Mount of Transfiguration?
Three.
What was the rest of them? What was the other nine?
Sleep.
Where are the nine this morning? Sleep. Sleeping with excuses. I thought about it. I said, you know, mother, they play football in the snow.
Yeah,
you think they're going to cancel a Super Bowl game because it's snowing? Have y'all ever seen football play? And you know, why these folks got to be crazy. Freak. And some of them don't even have no shirt.
Mm-hmm.
Because they got passion for the game. You got what? How far will your passion for what you want, for your assignment, how far will it carry you?
Come on now.
Can it carry you to the point of change?
Hello.
That you can believe in?
Mm-hmm.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is change you really can believe in.
Yeah.
Are y'all hearing this truth?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Ooh, man, I tell you, I'm expecting some things.
Amen.
I'm expecting some things. Mother, I'm expecting some things. I'm expecting some things. I got to understand it. That God's mission, when he sent Jesus, was not to get us to heaven.
Come on now.
But it was to get heaven to us.
Come on now. There you go.
That was the mission.
Yeah, Lord.
That was the mission. The kingdom of heaven is now. The kingdom of heaven is nigh thee.
Hello. Now.
Why is it nigh thee? Because it's in you.
Mm-hmm.
Christ in you, the hope of glory. I want to go to heaven. You better come by the kingdom.
Say.
It's nigh thee. Even in thy heart and in thy mouth.
Wow.
This is the word of faith. Come on, which we speak. When God says, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth. He's not talking about the planet. He's talking about you being just like earth. Because if you like it, the earth will be like it. If he never gets you like it, then the earth won't be like it. Are y'all hearing this truth?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. The resurrection was all about you becoming like him in the earth. 1 John what? 4:17. As he is, so are you in heaven. He didn't say that. He said, as he is, so are you in the earth. As he is, so are you in the earth. Are you? The emphasis is on you, not the earth. If you don't become, the earth still won't have it. You just missed that. Let me say that again. As he is, so 1 John 4:17 says, as he is, so are you in the earth. People get excited about the earth. The subject within the sentence is not about the earth, it's about you. As he is, so are you. Where? In the earth. Earth can't receive like heaven till you become like heaven.
Come on.
When
now.
You become like heaven, the earth becomes like heaven.
Come on now.
Because you are a representation. You're an ambassador of heaven. You're an ambassador of the womb of God. You're an ambassador of the mind of God. You're an ambassador of the voice of God.
Yes,
hallelujah. You ain't hear that, not see it. Oh, I'm teaching better than you. Ain't got to say amen because the word is amen. Hallelujah.
Yes, it is. Hallelujah.
I'm a walking hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Even the palm tree breathes over. Come on. When you walk by, ooh, there's one of them.
Say.
You so anointed when you pass by a palm tree or a tree, it says, should we blow or stand still?
Glory
to Is anybody God. Hearing this truth?
Yeah.
Hmm? Is anybody hearing? Did y'all catch that?
Yeah.
Did y'all catch that moment a while ago?
Mm-hmm.
Did you see God's always in a moment?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Are y'all hearing this truth?
Yes, sir.
Oh, I feel this anointing of God. Mm-hmm. It says, chasing thy son while there is hope. And let not thy soul spare for his crying. We're going to hit 19 and 20. Proverbs 19:20. Hear counsel and receive instruction. Hear counsel and receive instruction. What I want to talk to y'all? The miracle is in where? In the instruction. Hear counsel and receive instruction that thou mayest be wise in the latter end. If you hear now, you'll be wise in the latter end. Hear now. Hear ye, hear ye. Hear now and you be wise in it. And when what's the latter end? Testing time. That's the latter end.
Yeah.
Testing time. If you I'm giving you all the answers now. So when the test comes, pass it. Because it's in you to pass. Because I'll give you an open book. My wife used to say something on the job and she said, honey, you ain't gotta fail the test. That's an open book. You just gotta know how to get there.
Yeah. Say.
See, my wife is real sharp.
Yeah.
And when I first started working for the government, I wasn't getting it. I wasn't getting it because I was trying to do it on my own without the book.
Yeah.
I was trying to remember it, but it was so much. Mother, I couldn't contain it. He said, honey, you will pass the test if you know how to navigate to the answer. You gotta know when you're in trouble how to navigate to God, how to navigate to the answer, how to navigate to the principle.
Come on now.
In the midst of darkness, you gotta be able to grope for the light.
Right.
If you can remember where the light switch is. You know what?
Come on.
I'm so used to being in my house, let's call my house the place of God. God's favorite place is in my house.
Amen.
That's one of his favorite spots, not the Bahamas, at my address.
See?
He loved to visit my address. He loved to hang around my office.
Amen.
God just loved. I follow him, but God followed me too.
Come on now.
He said, where you from? God, I like your swag.
Same.
That's all right.
What about you? It's the, what's your house? It's the place where God will be. I've been at my house so long now, if all the lights go out, I know where the light switch is.
Mm-hmm.
It can be out. I'll find my way because I know the area. You ought to be able to walk with God so long when darkness comes, you got to find the light. You got to find the switch. You got to find the prophetic principle. You got to find, come on, the key that unlocks the door. Come on, you got to know whether you got to grope for the key. You ain't heard nothing I said.
Come on now.
Come on here. Oh, that ain't no power failure because the light bills pay.
Say.
Come on. Darkness in your life, that ain't no power failure. He paid, Jesus Christ paid the price.
Say.
Baby, that light gonna come back on me. If you go, if you switch again,
mm-hmm.
You ain't heard nothing I said.
Say.
Glory to God.
Come on here.
Thank you, Lord.
Is anybody here in this here?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
We moved in a new home, and one day, part of the house, the light was on one side, but the other side, the lights weren't on, Mother.
Mm-hmm.
I said, wait a minute. This ain't got nothing to do with the price. The bill being paid, because
mm-hmm.
all the lights would be off if the bill wasn't paid.
Mm-hmm.
I said, something's going on.
Mm-hmm.
So when I called headquarters in, they call Encore.
Mm-hmm.
That's the source of all the lights.
Okay.
All the energy places got to answer to Encore.
Mm-hmm.
Encore, what's on your bill? Let something happen. What Encore show up?
Okay.
I'm with Atmux. I'm with Stream Energy. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Let something really happen. For real?
Yeah.
Ain't none of them coming out. Encore.
Encore.
Right. Encore.
Yes.
They hold everybody. Is anybody here? Is it?
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of times you gotta go past religion.
Come on now.
Come on. To get the truth.
Say.
You gotta go to the source. Come on here.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta go where the life is.
That's right.
Is anybody here in this truth?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Are you hearing this, Michael? Is this making sense? Hear counsel and receive it. Hear counsel and receive instruction.
Mm-hmm.
Hear counsel and receive instruction. Hear counsel and receive instruction.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. That thou mayest be wise in the latter end.
Mm-hmm.
Come on here. Do we hear that?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
The desire of a man is his kindness, and a poor man is better than a liar. The fear of the Lord tendeth to life, and he that has it shall abide satisfied. He shall not be visited with evil. We're hearing this here? Stay tuned. Listen. A slothful man hideth his hands in his bosom. That's a man that don't want to do nothing. He just want to talk about the problem. He just want to complain about it. Nothing changed because you pissed off.
Come on now.
Nothing changed because you don't like it. If you don't like the food ain't gonna change because you don't like it. You got all again.
Say.
Is anybody hearing this truth?
Yes, sir.
A slothful man hideth his hands in his bosom and will not so much as bring it to his mouth again. See, that's a lazy man. A man that won't try to help himself. Come on now. Is anybody hearing this here? Mm-hmm. Let's look at 27. It says, cease, my son, to hear the instructions that cause it to err from the words of knowledge. If I'm going to cease from anything, I'm going to cease from things that come against my knowledge, cause me to err. Things that caused me to get in that place of with a bad spirit. Depression, oppression. Don't want me to go further. It said cease. So sound like to me, that's a decision. I got to decide whether I'm going to continue in error or whether I'm going to continue in truth.
Amen.
And can I be honest with you? Sometimes it looks like there's more people following error than there is truth. You better get with truth.
Amen.
Because sometimes error, it got a room full. Amen. Standing room only where Harry is. Harry is. Standing room only. Mm-hmm. Truth. Because sometimes fat look like growth. Mm-hmm. But eating a lot of fat, it'll kill you.
All right.
I don't want the growth that's fat. I want the growth that lasts.
Mm-hmm. I'm on now. Mm-hmm.
Are you following me, Mother?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Someone says action time.
It's action time.
Someone says action. I done talked about it, I done wrote about it, I'm going to be about it.
Yes.
It's time to be about it.
Yes,
come on.
Yes.
It's time to take your spirit and ignite somebody else with it.
Hello.
When you start doing it, people going to start falling y'all in the dark. Sometimes you got to expose yourself to more. You keep exposing yourself to the same thing, you got to put yourself around more.
Amen.
Are you following what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Life will give you anything that you willing to pay the price for. Let me say that again, Mother. Life will give you anything that you willing to pay the price for.
Right.
Are you that young man? You're that little prophet?
Yes.
Y'all hear that? You're that priest? Life will give you anything if you're willing to pay the price. You come in and say, oh, I love to play the games on the computers. Why don't you be the man that make the games? Come on in. Why don't you be the man that draw the cartoons? Mm-hmm. I love computers. Why don't you be the man that makes the computers?
Yeah.
See? It's always a man behind the man or a woman behind the woman. Let me say that.
Come on now.
But when I talk about, I'm talking about mankind, so that covers all genders.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Are we here? Are we hearing this truth?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
See, when you're going for greatness, you can't be a slugger. Mm-hmm. When you're going for greatness, you can't be full of excuses.
Come on now.
When you're going for greatness, you can't let you stop you.
Hello.
Let me say that again. You can't let you, if anybody stop you, the first enemy gonna go to Mary, gonna look just like you.
Mm-hmm.
You the same person that says yes, go back in the mirror, you can be the same person and tell yourself no. You can talk yourself in it, or you can talk yourself out of it.
Come on, man.
How many of you did that? How many of you talk yourself in something?
Mm-hmm.
And then you find yourself talking yourself out of it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, she wanted it. Ain't nobody gonna be there, nobody care. Ain't nobody gonna be there anyway. And see, you now you're drawing up that expectation. Someone said that the other day, are we doing ministry? Are we doing ministry? I don't see no reason to stop. You slid on ice to go to work, to a job that you didn't like, didn't pay you enough. God trying to get you increase. You went to work sick. Your leg was broken in a cast at work. Why can't it be a cast in the presence of God? Maybe fall off in His presence.
Say.
You know, people do it. People silly. They want the world and ain't got no sacrifice. Mother, no sacrifice. Come on, you be like Mother. Throw your meek hat on, your meek coat, and come on in this world. Mother wasn't feeling nothing. Come on in this spot. She didn't just come in. I mean, you know, she didn't come in with a coat. She just gonna walk in here with the goodness of God all wrapped around.
Yeah.
I made it for I can wear a meek when I get ready. I was like, I felt a prison before I looked around. I felt something rich coming in. Looked up there, that Mother Ford on all that wood. I'm trying to see who it is under that. I mean, she was under that. You ain't hear nothing I see.
All right.
Come on. That's what tithe and offerings are doing.
Amen.
So to keep you healthy.
Wealthy and wise.
Come on here. Not just a meat coat. Come on here. But a meat has to go. That's like, guess what? That's just one of the things tithes and offerings are doing. Come on here. You can do the rest too.
Yes, amen.
And doing it.
Yeah.
Are we hearing this truth?
Yes, sir.
Okay, it says in Proverbs 20 and 4 says, the slugger will not plow by reason of cold. Therefore shall he beg in the harvest and have nothing. See, that's the slugger. Always with an excuse.
Yeah.
I can't come. I don't have enough this. This and that. See, that's a slugger.
Mm-hmm.
You know you're talking to a slugger because a slugger ain't going to talk vision. He's going to talk problem.
Come on now.
I'm telling you, you know when you're talking to a slugger, because they're not going to sound like you. They ain't going to want to do what you're doing.
Say.
Oh, slugger. But they want to harvest, but too lazy to plow the field. Mm-hmm. Too lazy to plant themselves.
Come on.
They just won't. One time I had one family member, I was treating him out to eat. He said, well, you know, I don't eat this kind of chicken. I said, do you have any money? No. That spirit told me, the spirit, young spirit too. He's a young spirit, about 18 or something, 19, 17, somewhere along that old young spirit. I'm treating, right? And so I go to buy, and nobody complained, but if you don't work, don't have no money. Well, you know, I don't eat this kind of chicken. I said, you eat it today? He said, well, they buy me. I'm not buying that. This is what I'm buying. I got more money than you, and I eat this. You gonna eat it today, or you won't eat.
Say.
Just a slugger. Mm-hmm. See what I'm saying? They got an order, but they ain't got no money to pay for the order.
You ain't heard nothing I say. Anybody hear this?
Oh, don't go like y'all don't know about no sluggers.
Mm-hmm.
You may have been one who came in your life. Come on, if you want one, I'm sure you know some.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You ever did for somebody and you jump and they weren't high enough that they still feel like you didn't jump high enough.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You bought them one thing, they wanted something else. Mm-hmm. But they had nothing to give you.
Say
nothing.
But you don't like what I bought you, but you need enough on your mind to buy me. You ain't nothing I said.
Say.
But I made that young man think he'll never do that one again. Because you know something my grandmother told me years ago? No one has to be nice to you. Nobody owes you nothing. Huh? Mm-hmm. And especially when you become grown, nobody owes you nothing. Mm-hmm. Anything I do for you when you big as me is a favor. Mm-hmm. You hear nothing I just said. Hey, I don't owe you nothing.
Amen.
That's the truth.
Well, this happened when I was a child. You better get over it.
Say. Mm-hmm.
Because I ain't going to go back and relive it with you. Or if you're talking about childhood, let me bring mine up too. When I thought about childhood day, I made it through, you make it.
Say.
You heard nothing else? See, my father wasn't there, mine wasn't either. But I love him, we got a good relationship today.
Amen.
It's what it's supposed to be, it's doing what it's supposed to do.
Amen.
Yeah.
Sometimes you got too many expectations on people, that's why you get disappointed.
Right.
Because you done made people God and they ain't God. They just so they are people, and they subject to change their mind anytime. Your hope better be in God. I'm talking today.
Yes.
I'm preaching today.
Yes, yes.
I'm going to see them to my own self.
See?
Hold on.
See, mother, I just don't stop putting certain expectation on people. See, I don't put that. That's sometimes, how you going to put a certain expectation on people and you know they ain't qualified for that expectation?
Say.
You expect this person to be on time. You know they're untimely. So why do you expect them to be timely? Why are you expecting a rude person to act kind?
Come on now.
You ain't hear nothing I say. Why are you putting that expectation on people? You got to draw that expectation back. Now, watch this here. That don't mean you're not supposed to do what you're supposed to do.
Hello.
Because, see, I'm not going to alter my relationship with God because you're doing a certain thing. God, he going to change it. But you know what? I'm not going to wait on you to change. I'm going to keep being me because there's some things I need from God.
Say. All
right.
That ain't got nothing to do with you.
Right.
Come on. Yeah, come on now. Mm-hmm. You going to hold up what you want from God because of your past? Mm-hmm. Now, if they want it, you can come back and get it, but I'm going to move on and get mine. All
right. Say.
Amen.
Are you hearing me, Sister Joan?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So we got that. Okay. Now let's look at. Okay. Let's look at Proverbs 19. And 11. You want to be known? Let me show you what you're gonna be known by. Who wanna be known? Who would like to be known?
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Let me show you how you're gonna be known. Proverbs 19:20. And 20 and 11. Even a child is known by his doing. Whether his work be pure and whether it be right. You're known by your doing. I know what you said, but what you're doing. I know what your mouth said, but what you're doing. End of the day, okay, I know what you said on the application, but let me see what day's work you did. Let me see how your day was. Let me show you what you're doing. Let me show you who you're talking to. Let me tell you, let me show you where you've been. That's what you're doing. What do you spend your most time? That's what you're doing. You're going to be judged by your doing. You're going to be rewarded by your doing. I know you went by the bank, but did you make an investment?
Same.
You may drive by the bank every day, but what did you do at the bank? Did you fill out the form? Did you make a deposit? I know you came through the doors, but did you receive? I know you wrote notes in the book, but did you activate the notes in your spirit? Did you activate the notes to become a living epistle of what you wrote? Are y'all hearing me, young men? Success, young men, do not discriminate. You're not too old to be successful. You're not too old to be like God, too young to be like God. You're not too young to be successful. It's kingdom talk. Some say the kingdom pep talk.
The kingdom pep talk.
It's kingdom talk, man. I go back and rehearse the voice of God. Come on. Put your life on rewind. Come on, go back and hear this again. Faith come by hearing. Hearing by the word of God. Faith come by hearing. Hearing by the word of God.
Amen.
And every time God speaks, he's speaking wisdom and knowledge. 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 And I'm telling you something. I'm expecting something great every time I come in the presence of God. Amen. I'm not going to sit up, Sister Joan, and wait for failure.
Come on now.
Sit up and think crazy. Mm-hmm. Why are you going to waste your energy, your mind, thinking crazy? Man, you ought to be holding the truth back from somebody.
Say.
I don't get in my flesh and just because something ain't looking well. I can't hold truth back from you. I'm going to say, you going to church? Yeah, I'm coming. Sister Margot told me, she said, oh, we have? I said, yes, we are. So I want to know, we going to be on the phone? No, we ain't been on the phone. Why could you say it? Because I traveled to the office this week. It took me two hours and 50 minutes to get from my government office to home. And you think I ain't finna come? It's better condition than it was the other day.
Come on,
and you think I'm going to hold back? And God done spared my life?
Amen.
God blessing me? Mm-hmm. You hear nothing. And the first thing I told Brother Anthony, with life, health, and strength.
Come on, man. That's it.
Come on here.
Yes, Lord.
Man, you'd be surprised the stuff you take for granted. Mm-hmm. I said, you'd be surprised the stuff you take for granted. Mm-hmm. Are y'all here a minute? You'd be surprised the stuff you take for granted. Mm-hmm. You ain't worried about no house when you got two eyes you can see. You got arms you can raise. You walked in here. Man, look at here. It ain't bad as you think it is.
Come on now.
Well, life could be better. It could be worse too.
Hello.
Somebody wish they had your situation right now, all of it. You'll find out you ain't talking about nothing. Meet some people. You say, ooh, I'm glad to be me.
Yeah.
You met somebody, say, ooh, thank God. Mm-hmm. Not making mockery of nobody else, but I'm saying, oh, I thank God to be me.
Amen.
As good as it is.
Yes, Lord. Thank you.
Is anybody hearing this truth?
Amen.
Listen to this here. Verse 12. Proverbs 20, verse 12. The hearing ear. In the seeing eye. Someone said the hearing ear and the seeing eye. Say, God, give me a hearing ear and a seeing eye. It's a bad thing to have an ear but can't hear nothing. Have eyes, can't see nothing. Can't hear nothing in the spirit. Can't see nothing in the spirit. Is anybody hearing this?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. The hearing ear and the seeing eye, the Lord has made both of them. You got to learn to see past what you see. You got to learn to hear past what you hear.
Amen.
See, if it don't make you happy, what you hear, don't receive it. If what you're looking at don't make you happy, look past it and see a way to change it in a positive manner. Can you follow what I'm saying, son?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. The hearing ear and the seeing eye, the Lord has made both of them. Love not sleep, lest thou come to poverty. Mm-hmm. Love not sleep. In sleep is excuses. People go to sleep that's full of excuses. People go to sleep that don't want to do nothing. People go to sleep that are tired. Mm-hmm. And you know you can get tired of doing nothing. You know, if you sit around, how many of us been home on a Saturday and you call yourself going to rest, but you overrest?
Mm-hmm.
Now you didn't rest, now you're sluggish.
Yeah.
And you did better to get on up early in the morning, got some energy and move. Now you done sit around so long, it's 5 o'clock, you're still in your pajamas. Slugger. Is anybody hearing this here?
Yes, sir.
Love not sleep. Come on, that's Proverbs 20 and 13. Love not sleep, lest thou come to poverty. If you don't do nothing, your life is going to be a reflection of poverty in every area of your life. Spiritually, physically, mentally, and financially. Poverty is a form of lack. Something's missing. Just like you can be prosperous in every area of your life. Nothing missing, nothing broken. Is anybody hearing this here?
Yes, sir.
Love not sleep, lest thou come to poverty. Open thy eyes, and thou shalt be satisfied with bread or provision. Bread is symbolic of provision. Open thy eyes. Let's read this again. You've got to get this. Proverbs 20 and 19 and 13. Love not sleep, lest thou come to poverty. Open thy eyes, and thou shalt be satisfied with provision. Open thy eyes. Open the eyes of thy understanding. Open your third eye. So you got to learn to see with your mind, not with your physical eyes. Because sometimes your physical eyes will deceive you. So you got to learn to see with your mind.
Amen.
Because even right now, you're looking at me, you're seeing something with your third eye. You're seeing something with your mind. You've been looking at somebody and seeing something else. Mm-hmm. And you could tell when you was intense of seeing something. That's what you're seeing. When somebody said something, you said, what'd you say? Anybody ever did that? You were looking at them, but you were seeing something else.
Mm-hmm.
You said, what'd you say? Mm-hmm. I mean, one time I was in a party and my body was in one place and somebody was talking and my body was there, but my spirit had left and went to the other room.
Right.
And so when they said something, I said, what'd you say? Because
mm-hmm.
I had left. Because what they were saying, my body stayed there, but my spirit, it couldn't hold it. It left
mm-hmm.
and went to another conversation.
Yeah.
Are we hearing this truth?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, let's look at Proverbs 20 and 18. When we're ready to come to a close, we'll have a little short review. Is this blessing anybody?
Amen.
I'm not trying to preach at you. I'm trying to teach you. You're not preaching unless you reach it. I think everybody can identify
Amen.
With what has been said and that is being said after what has been said. See, your notes are still speaking. If you open back up, your notes still open back up. Your notes still be speaking to you. Open them notes up in a week. Something else will come out of them notes. You can write notes from your notes because this word is pregnant.
Yes.
You ain't hear nothing I said. Think I'm lying this week? Go home, open these same notes up, and start to get a blank and looking up and watch precept upon precept. Watch that word come out of a word.
Mm-hmm.
Ezekiel said, I seen a wheel in the middle of a wheel.
Come on now.
I see a wheel, but there was another wheel in the midst of a wheel. You follow what I'm saying? That word pregnant.
Yes.
Okay, let's stay with me in spirit. And we're almost done. Proverbs 20, verse 18. Every purpose is established by counsel, and with good advice, make war. every purpose is established with counsel. 7, I'm speaking over your purpose now. It's been established with counsel, with the counsel of God. It's been established. What does 2 Corinthians 2:20 say? Believe God, and so shall you be established. God is the one that established. Believe his prophets. Once I establish you in truth, then I send the prophet to confirm that I established. That's why you mean that's confirmation. Even if it, word of knowledge is something that you know, word of wisdom is something that's confirmed. I feel that. I bear witness to that. See, God then breathed over you already. So when the presence of God comes, you know it's Him. The Bible said, try the Spirit by the Spirit, see it's of God.
Yes.
So you know, brother, the Spirit of God. Certain things the enemy just ain't going to tell you.
Come on now.
Come on. The enemy ain't going to tell you you're blessed. The enemy ain't going to tell you you'll be healed. The enemy ain't going to tell you you can make it. Are we hearing this truth? Okay, Proverbs 20:6, and I'm going to close it with, then we're going to talk. Proverbs 20:6. Most men will proclaim everyone his own goodness. Proverbs 20:6. Most men will proclaim his own goodness, but a faithful man who can find? A faithful man. A faithful person. Who can find? A faithful person. That's a person that ain't driven by conditions. Ain't driven by adversity. Ain't moved by what they see, mother. Ain't moved by what they feel. Take a lick and what they say, keep on ticking. Ain't moved by roadblocks. Roadblocks are not denials. Roadblocks don't stop God. He's a mountain moving God. He's a God that's known to make the crooked places straight. Amen?
Amen.
He's a God that cannot lie. If he said it, he'll bring it to pass.
Hello.
Mother, did he just get him? Just get him to say it, he's gonna bring that to pass. I don't care what it looks like. Mother, he's gonna bring that to pass. Let me tell you, if God said it, you will outlive the lie. Somebody better write that down. If God said it, you will outlive the lie. Well, they said this here. No, you're going to outlive that lie that the doctor told you. You're going to outlive that symptom in your body. You're going to outlive that. You're going to outlive that spiritual battle in your mind, them thoughts that's contrary against the word of God. Because we're going to stand on the principle that say, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing into captive every thought unto the obedience of Christ.
Hello.
Amen?
Amen.
Y'all been blessed by the word?
Amen.
Talk to me, Sister John.
Say, don't be moved by emotions.
And you, what you got out of it? Don't be moved by emotions.
Resurrection is for you to become like him, like Jesus.
Amen.
And I also put my house in the place where God wants to be.
Don't be moved by emotions. Because they are subject to change, but God's word won't. Amen?
Amen.
Amen, mother? What you got? Mother said, don't let this world system rule over you. Don't let it lord over you. God created us to be creators. He created us to have dominion and authority and to be fruitful and to multiply. Don't let the system overtake you. Okay, so mother, you got some of that, mother?
Yes, let God go and you go with God. Let him lead you.
Let God go and you go with God. Let him lead you. Come on now. Let him lead you. Because he know where it's at. Holy Spirit know where it's at.
Come on now.
He know where it's at. When you can't find it, okay, Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not depending on you now. Time is of the essence. God, you know what this is.
Yes.
God, I don't want to waste time. You ever said, I'm God, I don't want to waste time with this person. If this ain't it, if this ain't the business partner, if this ain't the deal, I don't want to do this. Amen? Anybody hearing this here? Mm-hmm. All right, Dr. Priest, what you got?
Believe God and you will be established.
Believe God and you will be established. Now see, he's focused. Notice he didn't talk about the latter part. He said, believe God in you. He said, let me get established first. Because I can't get to the prophet till I'm established mm-hmm. by God. Mm-hmm. Till he set the principles in me. Mm-hmm. I won't be able to identify with his angels till he established me.
Come
on. Amen. Boy, that sounds like a man that's going to be somebody.
Yes,
God established me. If you just establish me, I'll prosper. I can get it for myself if you establish it.
All right. Mm-hmm.
But did y'all hear that? Mm-hmm. Little prophet, what you got?
If the lights are off and the Holy Spirit, you have to know who they are.
Huh? He said, if the lights are off, you got to know the Holy Spirit to know where they are. You ain't. Come here, young man. Come here.
Say.
Prophet Elijah coming to a city near you. Look at that camera. Look at the YouTube world and tell them what you just said.
If the lights are off, you have to know the Holy Spirit to turn them on.
You hear that? In other words, if the lights are off in your life, you better know the Holy Spirit. Because he know where the switch is to turn them on.
Come on now.
And he'll turn you on to.
Right.
Come here, Dr. Priest. Tell the YouTube world what you just said. What you got? What you just
said? Believe God and you will be established.
Believe God and you shall be established. 2 Chronicles 20:20 said, believe God and so shall you be established. Believe his prophets and so shall you prosper. Now, he didn't mention the last part because he said, God, if you just establish me, the rest will follow.
Yes.
Establish me in present day truth. Establish me to be the man of God that I should be. Yeah, come on, little prophet. Oh, these are giants.
Mm-hmm.
This is my legacy.
All right.
You want to know? I got in the books. These are my books.
All right.
I've been inking on them about 10 years or better. Right. Go ahead and read. I mean, go ahead and prophesy. I mean, go ahead and talk. I'm sorry. I'm stepping in dispensations now. Go ahead. Whatever you heard God say. Whatever you heard God say.
Don't let a fool judge you by your beliefs.
Huh. Did you hear that? Don't let a fool judge you by your beliefs. How can a fool have you to doubt your God?
Right.
He said, don't let a fool judge you.
Amen.
You hear nothing I said. A fool. Come on. That's all right. God, it's a fool. Come on. Come on. Come on. Go ahead.
Life will get anything if you sacrifice for it.
Life will give you everything if you sacrifice for it. This is Dr. Priest Mathunderman coming to a city near you.
Come on now.
All right, Dr. Priest.
Okay, come on, Mike. Come on up here. This is another entrepreneur. Another businessman.
Life will give you anything that you're willing to pay.
Life will give you anything that you're willing to pay the price for. Price is not an issue.
Come on now.
When you know who holds the source, the sources.
Yes, sir.
Anything else?
It's expensive to quit.
It's expensive to quit. Are you hearing me? It's expensive to quit. That's good, Mike. It costs more to quit than it do to start.
Amen.
It costs more to quit college than it do to start college.
Come on now.
Yeah. Ignorance is expensive.
Yes, it is.
It costs more than education.
All right.
Come on, Sister Margo.
God's mission for Jesus was not to get us to heaven, but to get heaven to us.
God's mission for Jesus was not to get us to heaven, was to get heaven to us. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. He was talking about you becoming like the kingdom. And when you become like the kingdom, the planet becomes like the kingdom.
Amen.
If you don't become like the kingdom, the planet won't either.
See?
That's why heaven follows the person, not the place. The person impregnates the place.
All right.
If you got heaven in you, heaven's coming by your address.
Right.
You ain't heard nothing I'm saying. Come on, sister.
Amen.
Any more there?
Yes.
If you won't make time for wisdom and knowledge in the day of adversity, wisdom and knowledge won't make time for you.
If you won't make time for wisdom and knowledge in the day of adversity, it won't make time for you. Amen. Sister Joan?
Take off the shades of ignorance, doubt, unbelief, because right does not always feel right, and my feelings will not nullify the truth in me.
Right will always not feel right. Right is not a feeling, it's a decision. You might want to write that down. Right is not a feeling, it's a decision. Papas, you got anything?
God's guidance.
Are you coming up? Okay.
God's guidance is a balance of instruction and discipline.
God's guidance is a balance of instructions and discipline. That's good. God's guidance is a balance of instructions and what?
Discipline.
And discipline. Mm-hmm. You want guidance? That's the protocol. That's how it's going to flow. Amen? Amen. Well, I thank God for everybody. And if this word has been a blessing to you, you share it with someone else. Amen?
Amen.
Spread the love. Amen. Spread the love in the YouTube world. Spread the love throughout the world. Spread the love through the congregation. Spread the love in your neighborhood. Amen?
Amen.
Someone say,